All right, so here we have some beautiful, beautiful Muscovy duck legs. Just take these aside. So here's the beautiful Muscovy duck legs, right? This is from a female bird. The reason you can tell is because they're smaller legs. Sometimes you'll get duck legs that are massive, almost like a pound or so in size. Those are generally from the male, the males. So the ladies have smaller legs. A lot of people kind of confuse what to do with duck. They're a little afraid. It's not something you come across very regularly in North American cooking. But it is making a comeback, and there's a reason for that, because duck has some of the best flavored meat that you can find. See this dark, rich meat here? If you braise that for a long time, or what the French do is confit it, which is basically poaching it in its own fat for a long time, so this meat ends up falling off the bone, becoming super tender and just delicious. Okay, so the thing people have a lot of issues with the duck is the amount of fat. People think, oh, they don't want fat in their meals, all this kind of stuff. Now, duck actually has a tendency to, once you slowly cook it, especially duck legs, you cook that properly, you're gonna end up with a very, very succulent meat, but the fat itself will render off. And what that means is when you cook it, the skin will stay on, but the fat underneath the skin will melt off and will stay in your pan if you are actually eating the meat. So you don't even have to eat that fat. There will be a little bit of residual fat, but that's all good. Now, duck legs, basically, what I would do, you wanna do a classic, easy peasy little stew. You take some onions, garlic, carrot, and celery, and you saute that off in a nice pan. When those are nice and caramelized, you're gonna make sure you season it properly with salt and pepper, some bay leaves and thyme, maybe a little juniper berry if you have it. Now when that's all done, you get a little bit of a port or red wine and you splash that in there, maybe like half an inch, let that bubble away. After that, you're gonna put in a little bit of chicken stock. And when that comes to a simmer, you just lay these bad boys right on top of that stock and that little mess of vegetables in there. So now you're looking at what, like 15 minutes of cooking time so far, right? You wanna make sure you get in enough chicken stock just so that the legs are barely covered, okay? Get that simmering, pop a lid on the pot, in the oven at 325, and an hour and a half later, you have some of the best tender, awesome duck legs you can have, okay? You serve that with a little bit of salad, a little bit of roasted crisp potatoes, whatever you want, you got yourself a beautiful meal. So that's it, fast and easy approach to duck legs.